Okay, this welcome to session 10A of the program Making Your Funnel Work. We're going to talk about LinkedIn advertising. This will be the last session of this program. So let's dive in. What we're going to talk about, some stats, advertising strategy, targeting, ad formats, matched audiences, conversion tracking, ad positions, campaign goals, and A/B testing. Well, LinkedIn is the second most popular platform for B2B marketers, followed by Facebook. As of January 2020, 663 million users have been reached with LinkedIn ads. Research shows that the most engaging LinkedIn posts are published on Wednesday morning and on Thursday afternoon, Thursday morning and noon, and Friday morning. LinkedIn's lead conversion rates are three times higher than other big platforms, including Google. Close to 50% of marketers are creating content for LinkedIn. Only 10% of marketers say they're investing in LinkedIn. And in a study of over 5,000 businesses, HubSpot found that traffic from LinkedIn generated the highest visitor lead conversion rate at 2.74%. Almost three times higher than other social platforms. Some LinkedIn post best practices. And it's maybe a little bit strange regarding this. We're going to talk about ads, but of course, it also has to do with your advertising strategy. Make your titles between 40 to 49 characters long. Make your post on LinkedIn visual. Add up to 8 images. Don't add videos or other multimedia assets to your post. Use how-to or list style headlines. Divide your post into 5 headings in order to attract the greatest number of post views. People like long read on LinkedIn, 1900 to 2000 words long. Neutral articles work best, so or be dual in your opinionating or stay away from opinionating. Make your content really easy to read. Well, first we're going to talk about LinkedIn matched audiences. It's something similar than Facebook custom audiences. You can implement a pixel on your website, and you can track web visitors to your entire domain or certain web pages. You can upload lists of businesses. So that's not personal identifiable information in case if it's no single person companies. So you can do that. Or you can upload a list of contacts, and that will be mostly considered personal information. So you do need permission to share it with LinkedIn according to GDPR, but there are some exceptions. And we're going to talk about that. And from the business lists, LinkedIn recommends uploading at least 1,000 companies, but the minimum is 300. And you can match them upon company name, company website, email domain, LinkedIn page URLs or the business page or a stock symbol. And you can also include some additional fields as industry, city, state, country, or zip code increases the accuracy of your match. And on the second page, for persons, contact lists, LinkedIn recommends uploading at least 10,000 contacts. Also here, the minimum is 300. One of the following fields must be added to your list: email address, first and last name. Well, these two are personal identifiable information, but the other two are not, C and D. So your Apple ID, Apple mobile device ID, and Google user ID. And also you can here include other fields, but if you include other fields with the one of the IDs on the C and D, probably they are retraceable to a person, so it is GDPR. Interesting for you that both with LinkedIn matched audiences as also Facebook custom audiences, you can automate new contacts towards several matched audience lists, so behavior in other apps or on your website, etc., or in your CRM. So that can be really interesting to automate it. And on the right here, going back to the earlier page, you see here a table called data source, and this is what kind of retargeting segments you can create, of audience segments you can create on LinkedIn. So the first is people visit your company page on LinkedIn. The other is joined or watched an event on LinkedIn. And the third option is who filled in a lead generation form, lookalike audience on the other criteria, third party, uploaded list, what we just talked about, people watch your video or engage with your video or who visit your website. So the below and the third below, upload list and website, that are the mesh audiences we just discussed. But you can also create retargeting ads on LinkedIn based on other criteria. Well, then we have LinkedIn lookalike audiences. Build lookalike audience of any audience type you have created on LinkedIn, which I just forementioned. At least 300 contacts business have to be in your base list. It can be up to 15 times larger than your original base. Well, match is based on member and company similarities. Lookalike audiences do not use sensitive demographic attributes such as sex or age within the model. So that can be really interesting to do a test with these audiences if you have first, of course, have gotten success with your base audience group. But then the tracking pixel, of course, where here is in the text, your ID is an ID. LinkedIn will generate for you in the script. This is what it looks like. So it's just a basic JavaScript, which you can install through Google Tag Manager on your website or straight through. But I recommend using Google Tag Manager. Then you can also set up conversion tracking. Of course, you need to have the pixel installed, but under the drop down where you here see download other types of goals are, of course, possible, like downloads, lead forms, but also purchases, anything, but also event tracking. So clicked on a button or something like that. So why is it interesting? Because if you're optimizing for sales and you give LinkedIn data what kind of traffic does convert on your landing page, then can optimize your campaign for you. So it really helps. A really nice feature of LinkedIn is LinkedIn lead forms. I'm a big fan of it. You can create on the account assets, you can create all kinds of forms for download or anything you want. And you can automate the data integration through tools like Zapier. And all the information that LinkedIn has available for you in their database, they will pre-fill it for the user. So they just have to push submit or give an opt-in and submit or add some custom fields that you also need because of your business, but that are not already enriched data on the LinkedIn platform. So you really have to ask it yourself to the user. But the benefit for you is probably you will get a higher conversion rate on the LinkedIn platform, and it benefits that you make use of the LinkedIn branding and trust that people have in the LinkedIn brand. So can really recommend to you if you're in B2B or any other lead generation situation to test it. Well, then these are the types of campaign goals you can do within the LinkedIn ad network at this moment. Of course, brand awareness campaigns, website visits, engagement, video views, lead generation, website conversions, and job applicants, CV uploads, etc. And here you see on the what is it, the row heads, the column heads, you see all the types of ads you have on LinkedIn, and on the left the advertising goals on the row heads. And you see, for example, at the last ad, the job ads, you see only a green checkbox that you can only use that ad format with the ad goal job applicants. So, and another one is video views. Of course, you can only use the video ad to generate video views. The more general are brand awareness and website visits, and website conversions also. Well, no difference between website visits goal and website conversions goal. So they're really closely related, but you see, for example, with engagement, types of ads are not used. For example, not the message ads, just to make sure that we're going to talk about what the ad types are, but here's the overview. LinkedIn content promotion. Well, mostly we are here to talk about, of course, LinkedIn is in B2B mostly used for content distribution and promotion. Of course, your goal is, for example, lead generation or website traffic or followership on the LinkedIn platform. But mostly you will do that by creating and promoting content. So depending on what content, customer journey phase or format, you can adjust your advertising strategy. Like, did you post it organically on LinkedIn for reach engagement? Then you do an awareness, engagement, or video campaign. Do you want traffic to your own website and to build an audience there, retarget them, and etc.? Then you get a website traffic campaign. And do you want to generate leads? For example, you do a lead campaign with or without the lead form. And you could also send them to your website, but really try the lead form. So, what are the targeting possibilities? Of course, location and language, all the matched audience types, which you already discussed quite extensively, and all other non-personal data related information on LinkedIn that's possible. Well, what is possible? Well, you see it on some screen shots here on the right. On the company level, for example, they have company category, connections, followers of a company. So you can target the followers of a company, how fast the company is growing, industries, names. So you can upload a list of names. But demographics I skipped, education I skipped, but you can choose all levels of education or demographics. But job experiences, for example, very interesting, like job functions or seniorities or titles, skills they have. If you are looking for people who have a specific tool they use and they have it in their skill set, well, you can target those people based on that they tag their skill there. Years of experience in a job, etc. And the last option I pointed out here, interest and traits. Member groups can be really interesting, member interests or member traits. You can target all your advertising on that. So really interesting. Then you have the option to, when you book in a campaign, to choose or to opt in, or you have to opt out. I believe you have to opt out for the LinkedIn audience expansion. For similar attributes, exclusions will never be included. So if you include, you can, like I mentioned above, you can include or exclude the audiences that are here on the right. So for example, like you want to target all fashion CEOs in a certain country, but not if they're a sole proprietorship company. So you will exclude the sole, etc. So and the LinkedIn audience expansion makes it a little bit larger but similar, so not not as wide as with Google ads when you don't add any modifiers, keyword modifiers, but more similar. Like if you choose an online marketeer, they will also, if you enable LinkedIn audience, also digital marketeers and internet marketeers. If you don't, if you opt out for audience expansion, then it will only be online marketeers. So a special ad is the LinkedIn message ad. Sponsored email was the old brand name, I believe. It's a direct mail to awesome mail merch features, and but the, so you can personalize the email messages and use all the fields that they have available on LinkedIn in your email. So you can really personalize the email itself. LinkedIn text ad, that's a simple, just, I think the most simple, least visual ad that there is on the LinkedIn advertising platform. The spotlight ad are dynamically personalized ads. So in the ad, the user see his or her face, or if they don't have an image, their icon and their name. Like here in the example, and well, you can use it for more goals than you want, but it's, it can be really interesting to use this. Follower ad is to get more followers on your LinkedIn page, really specific goal. Conversation ad is a chatbot-like interface. You can integrate multiple call to action, and you have a progressive conversion path, and you learn also a lot about your audiences because you see which questions got answered by what the answers were. So you will learn more about your audience. It can be really interesting to use this ad format. The job set is, of course, is only for jobs, like it said, depending on how many openings you have available in general and specific for the matching with the candidate. But the ads have three different formats that are shown here. On the left, if you're three or more related openings, in the middle, if you're one or two related openings. And if you have no related openings but a lot, and you do target this group, then we'll see the ad format on the right here. All right, this was it about LinkedIn advertising. It was the last session of Making Your Funnel Work. Thank you for attending and participating. Good luck with your product and getting funding. And tomorrow I will send the recording. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.